Welcome to Suncoast U. I'm Stephanie Roberts. A college crackdown on bottles. And how long will a bottle of brandy preserve a wedding cake? An alarming answer.
I'm Rebecca Vargas. It's time to plan for the weekend with a Friday Fest preview and a new limited release local beer.
I'm Bo Beck. Today in Suncoast for Sale, we highlight active adult communities and all they have to offer in different price ranges.
And I'm Linda Carson. It's almost time for our new edition, but we need your help in picking a name for our Suncoast View puppy from Southeastern Guide Dogs. It's going to be here soon. We'll have details coming up. All that and more right now on Suncoast View.
In my clothing.
My scalp feel any more sore?
Should you tell them anything more?
Dance break. Ooh.
E. Ooh. Ah. Ooh. Ooh. E. Ooh. Ooh. Get off of me.
Ooh. Ooh.
Ooh. Ooh.
Scratch, scratch, scratch.
No, no offense. I didn't come up with the name. They are previewing their show, Vaudeville's Dead, coming up at the Starlight Theater this weekend. I want to talk to Kelly for just a minute. Tell me about your show.
Well, our show is a live, immersive theater piece that incorporates some of the golden hits of the stage and screen, Broadway. We cover everything. And we invite you to come and join the Plump Sisters for a filming of their famous Plump Sisters review.
All right, looks like a lot of fun. You can catch their four shows this weekend. For more information, you can go to starlightsrq.com. How'd you like that energy to start the show, ladies?
Okay, I've been looking at those ladies about an hour now, and it took me until now to figure out those are guys.
Yes, they? Linda, they are.
They're gorgeous. I want to get their makeup artist. Oh my goodness.
They know how to contour. That's what we were talking about.
Yeah, did you know they were guys?
Yes, and I think everyone else did too. But you.
I knew their hair wasn't real. I just thought they were wearing wigs.
Linda's been dipping into the
Well, hold on.
We'll get there. Welcome to the show. Welcome to Rebecca Vargas.
Thank
we have
you.
So much going on today. It's going to be a lot
you
of
really
fun.
Didn't know?
I really, cross my heart, did not know.
Well, now you know.
I thought the hair was a little wild, but I just thought.
So,
they
Linda,
were
there's this new
girls.
Thing. It's called drag.
And I don't think there's anything new about it, but that's okay. We do have something new in the kitchen, though. We are going to check in with Chef Mike from Station 400. And I think what's new is the sandwich that you've brought us. Tell us what we're previewing today.
Today we brought one of our top-selling sandwiches. It's our chicken salad croissant. It's in-house made mango chutney, chicken salad, with a couple of our side dishes as well.
Oh, that sounds like a lot of fun. We'll learn some secret ingredients to that chicken salad. And you also bought us a little goodie, which we appreciate. Tell us what we're drinking today.
You're drinking a elderflower cucumber mimosa. It's got elderflower syrup and cucumber syrup and with champagne.
Well, that sounds wonderful. So cheers, girls.
Cheers.
Linda, cheers to the dancers.
I thought cucumbers would be so good.
And it's so refreshing.
It is very refreshing. And, of course, Station 400 has lots and lots of styles of mimosa. So that's one of the wonderful things that you can
It's great
Definitely
for brunching.
Experience for brunching.
Yeah,
yes.
I love that.
Any time of day. Hey, we actually need to give a cheers to Ringling College because the Hollywood Reporter has come out with its list of the top film schools in the U.S. And once again, a Ringling firmly in that top 25. They've been ranked number 16
Incredible.
For top U.S. film school. So that's a big
deal.
Yes. Cheers
Absolutely.
To them.
Especially because it's a Suncoast school, and a lot of those students, they're getting jobs all over the country.
Yeah. That's the funny thing. This is an art school. They all have jobs when they graduate because they're doing graphic arts and all kinds of things that are in great demand. So when you graduate from Ringling, you go right to a job.
A lot of great alumni and also a big expansion that students are going to be able to work with in terms of sound studios and things like that. So it's great that that's right here on the Suncoast Suncoast. So cheers to you and congratulations for that top award. Well, it is time for our first hot topic. And speaking of colleges, alcohol on college campuses has long been an issue. Now, Stanford is banning full-sized bottles of hard liquor. The new policy says that hard liquor is completely banned at on-campus parties. And this is interesting, unless the party is exclusively graduate students. Apparently, we're supposed to get smarter as we get older. Then only mixed drinks are allowed. Translation, no shots. In the dorms, if students are 21, they can have liquor only if bottles are smaller than 750 milliliters. Now, that's the standard size for alcohol bottles. So the way they're doing it is making it harder to get a hold of. Stanford says those smaller bottles are harder to find in the stores. They hope this will discourage the alcohol culture on campus.
I went to a school where alcohol was banned on campus. That didn't mean that it wasn't in all the fraternity and sorority parties, and people just had their parties off campus.
Exactly. Yeah. That's what I was going to say. I don't think it's going to change much. Anything. Besides, how do you really monitor it? I know we've got our RAs and the RNs, but I don't know. It's college. You can't really monitor it.
You know what, though? People have got to learn to be responsible. Two people I went to college with died from alcohol.
Well, that's a problem.
Yeah, and I see it causing, you know, it takes a while to get old enough to see the problems happen. But I've seen alcohol hurt so many people. But I don't think banning it on a college campus will help because you just move off campus.
Yeah, I don't think it's going to help either. But I think because most colleges, it's not allowed anyway. Mm-hmm. And a lot of those kids are under 21 and they're drinking regardless, even though it's illegal. But what they do now is just make mixed drinks. They make like different punches and they call them different fancy names for each, you know, so it's still not going to fix the problem because the punch is okay.
It's not the bottle they're talking about.
Right, the problem is education. I mean, somehow we need to have the kids understand that this behavior can kill you, you know, like it's okay. If you're going to have a drink, have a drink. Don't have the whole bottle. And that tends to be the college culture.
I can see what they're doing is a good thing. They're trying to attempt to do that. But
I guess any attempt is better than no
attempt. No attempt, exactly.
And hopefully the education will continue. Well, half of all Americans do not have paid sick days. So not surprisingly, a new study says that paying people to stay home when they're sick results in fewer people in the office getting sick. The study compared regions of flu data and estimated that paid leave helped prevent 6% of influenza-like diseases. But Beth, that better not be what you have. Now, there's a name for this issue. It's called contagious presenteeism. That's when sick people go to work and infect coworkers. But Beth and I've been coughing for weeks here.
But you infected me.
Okay, hold on now. Experts say the flu kills thousands of people a year. So stay home if you have it and get your flu shot. My question is, why is it so hard for us to stay home when we're sick? I know what my reason is, because somebody else has to do my job.
Yeah.
And I feel terrible because you guys get stressed.
You know, I've never called in sick here in 21 years, but I've never been sick.
You better not get
it. What is Linda drinking?
Well, I'll probably just die.
No, don't say that. Oh, my God.
Without ever calling in sick, I'll be here. But I get my flu shots. I think that's why.
See, I'm like Linda, too. I don't like calling in sick, so I'm the person that would have, like, a flu and come into work. But I would try to do things to contain it. Like, I'll Lysol my things down. I won't touch certain things. I'll constantly wash
Would you call in sick if you had a paid day? I know we sort of do the way our time works.
Yeah, the way ours works.
I feel responsible. I feel like I'm letting down the team. Like, unlike most jobs, if we don't show up, someone has to still be in the seat.
Absolutely.
Someone still has to replace you in your duty. So then if I don't come, someone else is going to be inconvenienced.
But when people start getting sick, I carry one of those big things of the disinfectant rubs. And I wash down the car that I'm riding in with that guy.
Because we do share
really
so many things.
And then people don't want to get behind. I mean, we live in a country where vacations aren't taken. We keep seeing these studies because you don't want to get behind. So I think that's that mentality that I cannot miss a day of work because I'm going to get behind whether you're paid or not. But obviously it makes sense that if you're not paid, you don't want to miss because you need the money.
Right.
Well, my desk is a little medicine cabinet. I have everything in there from echinacea to
good. Like, now I know where to go.
But it hasn't cured your cough or mine. So.
Because you're contagious.
I love how this is going to be my fault regardless. Not contagious, but yes, I am still coughing.
Then why am I coughing? If you're not contagious, why do I have this?
It wasn't our fault.
I don't know. We're staying over here.
If I'm not here tomorrow, blame her.
Yeah.
All right. Well, now is the time to book your next getaway. And there's a name for this fall phenomenon. It's called cheap flight day. Late Tuesday, airlines dropped the prices of flights to signal the end of summer travel season. But it's not just a one-day event. Fares are typically lower now through Thanksgiving. And listen to this. Fares are expected to be extra low here in Florida It's not for a good reason. Fears about looming tropical storms and Zika are thought to discourage travel to and from our state. And I did check flights because I'm looking at a weekend in the fall, and they are down right now.
Really?
So if you're looking for travel, it's a good time to do it.
I'm going to Atlanta on Friday, and my ticket was about $150 less than it was when I went in May. Mm-hmm. But now I see there's a hurricane that's sort of threatening Sunday. That's when
Not yet, but maybe.
Possibly.
Not yet, but maybe.
Zika seems to be something that maybe is scaring a lot of people. I mean, I think it's starting to scare us residents now that we've got one very close to home, and it's spreading. By the mosquitoes, not by travel related.
I'm one of those people, I get bit by everything.
Me too.
So because of that, you know, I'm not saying I'm going to get pregnant tomorrow, but this is a whole 2-year thing. Like, so let's say I change my mind a year from now, I still wouldn't be able to get pregnant.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And well, then there's studies that say that it actually impacts an adult brain. So because you don't know what the actual dangers are, you have to be concerned.
And here's what I worry about. If I'm a mom in Ohio, per se, and I'm thinking about taking a family vacation this winter, I'm not going to come to Florida because there could be Zika. Like, why take the risk if you could go somewhere else? And I think that's going to
be the fear
tourism issue that we may have this year. And so that's unfortunate.
I have another selfish thing. Like, next to my house, there is a, I have like a really nice view of the Peace River. But that's because there's no home on the lot next to me. And someone just bought the lot and they're starting to build. And I hope that this hurricane and the Zika thing makes them change their mind.
Is that bad? Yes, that's
bad. You wouldn't wish it upon anybody.
Or just close your house into the river.
I'm like, please don't build
there. Our apologies if you bought the lot next to Bobeth on the Peace River. Oh, my goodness. All right, well, 60 years of marriage is quite an accomplishment. And so is making your wedding cake last that long. I'm telling you, only in Florida. Anne and Ken Fredericks of Satellite Beach celebrate their anniversary every single year by eating a piece of the top tier of their original wedding cake. Yeah, from 1955. Yeah. They claim the dark fruit cake, although it wasn't that dark, made by Anne's grandma, is just as tasty now as it was then, though it has turned black. This reminds me of Bobeth. It has never been in the fridge.
What?
And it's never been in the freezer. Bobeth always says we don't need to refrigerate things. That's what it says.
I thought at least it may have been frozen.
No, but listen. Okay, if you put liquor on it, is that what they did?
That's what they did. So it's a fruit cake.
No.
And, did you know this? Anne says it was made with enough brandy not to spoil. I don't believe this.
No.
And that they pour a shot over it every year when they take their little slice.
Oh, so you could pour a shot over dirt.
Well, I think it's the shot that makes it okay to them.
My daughter put the top of her wedding cake in my refrigerator almost eight years ago. Mm-hmm. I got it out about a month ago. It was like a rock. It had been frozen. Even after it defrosted, you drop it on the floor.
Oh, because the moisture had come out of it. So I'm in trouble because I recently celebrated my one-year anniversary, although it was 4 months ago. But we were traveling, so we didn't bring the cake. And there just hasn't been enough romantic occurrence at home to get it back out. So we haven't done it yet. And I think we do need to get to it.
I lost mine.
How did you lose a cake?
That's what I said.
Whose responsibility was
right,
the top tier cake?
Who took it from the reception?
I don't know. But hence why, probably why I'm getting a divorce. It should have been
because you didn't eat the cake. All right. I'm going to eat the cake this weekend. Make it all okay. But not in 61 years. Well, gold medal Olympic gymnast Allie Reisman is continuing her winning ways. She apparently has won the interest of an NFL player. Oakland Raiders tight end Colton Underwood said in a very public Yahoo Sports video that Allie Reisman should let him know when she's in San Jose and interested in going on a date. Apparently, former Olympic gymnast Shawn Johnson is married to another Raider player, and the group is all friends. So Reisman tweeted back, "Thanks for the sweet video. Looking forward to meeting you." Now the two are going on a blind date with their married friends.
How old is she? That's so cute.
I don't know how old she is. I'm sure she's young.
She's in her low 20s.
Oh, okay. Yeah, she was considered the mom of that gymnastics team, so I think she's in her low 20s. But a very public request for a date.
They have beautiful children, though. Very athletic children.
Very strong athletic children.
You know, would you want a public, I guess, proposal like that?
And so maybe she would have said no, so this could have backfired.
Yeah. I think he took a risk, because she could have said no just as publicly as she said yes.
I bet he knew that she was interested.
Yeah, since they have mutual friends,
and thought, hey, maybe this is a cute way to do it. Social media seems to be a thing that celebrities
have done. Yeah, I don't want any social media.
All right, don't ask Bobeth out publicly. She needs to keep it private. Well, we've all heard the chatter about people not liking the present political candidate choices. One Minnesota town found a way to make their town great again with a great Pyrenees for mayor. This is a gorgeous animal. Ooh. The town just elected 9-year-old Duke to a second term as mayor. Seriously? The original reign actually happened by accident a few years ago. Residents could pay a dollar to cast a vote for mayor, and there must have been a lot of yahoos in the race because the dog got the most votes.
Oh my gosh.
There's no doubt Duke is great as a great Pyrenees, or it's a doggone coincidence that he won again.
Well, what
he must have a great interview, too.
Did you just say it's a doggone coincidence?
I like that, Stephanie.
He won't do anything wrong. Yeah. He may not do anything right, but that's what we hope for in our cabinet.
But who's running the city?
Yeah, who really is running the city?
Is anyone concerned about that part?
He'll be nice to everybody, and that puts him far ahead in my book.
But he can be bribed.
Can't they all? All right, we're going to check in with our happy hour forecast when we come back. It's Suncoast for Sale.
Good afternoon. I'm Chief Meteorologist Bob Harrigan. Not as many storms along the coast this afternoon. That's due to a stronger northeasterly wind today. Sea breeze never really getting much of a chance to develop, so the showers are moving through rather quickly. I don't think we'll see a repeat of those strong storms like we saw yesterday where it was severe at times up near Pinellas. There'll be other showers popping up here and there like we're seeing right now just to the east and north of Port Charlotte. They're moving to the southwest, so Port Charlotte, you could see that storm kind of intensify here over the next hour or so. Right now, not nearly as hot today. More clouds around. Yesterday's high of 99. That was a record. There'll be no records today due to the increased cloud cover. And as far as the tropics go, lots of clouds near Puerto Rico. Reconnaissance aircraft investigating the area all afternoon long and did not find a closed low, which is a good sign. That means the system is not developing at this point. However, the National Hurricane Center is now suggesting an 80% chance that this will develop into the next cyclone as it makes its way to the west northwest. We'll have much more of that coming up today at 5. See you then.
And welcome back. Active adult communities are specifically designed to offer living options for those 55 years and older. Now, often they have resort-style amenities. And realtor Andrew Haddad is here to highlight some of the best adult communities on the Suncoast. Now, Andrew, I'm kind of surprised about this. You know, what allows them to have a 55-plus community?
Yeah, well, that's a great question, Bobeth. So the Federal Fair Housing Act prohibits against discrimination, yet there's exceptions to everything, which is the 55 plus rule. So they actually allow communities to register as 55 plus communities, which, you know, a lot of people moving down here. I mean, the amount of baby boomers we have down here, mm-hmm. some people are looking for those types of environments.
And I found this funny because when I first moved to Sarasota, I saw this great community that I wanted to live into. And I go there and I'm like, oh, can I stay? And they're like, no, it's 55 plus.
Of course.
And I was very shocked.
You were discriminated against.
I was.
Linda.
I was discriminated.
Would you want to be in a 55 plus?
But let's look at it because they're really very beautiful.
Could I take my 30-year-old boyfriend?
There you go.
There you go.
I'm there. No, here we go.
We
so Glen Oaks is, so I love starting at the price point because there's something for everyone. So $115,000 Glen Oaks. This is amazing. This is in Sarasota. Great community. We're looking at a 2-bedroom, 2-bath, 930 square feet, and believe it or not, this is the penthouse in Glen Oaks, so it's amazing. 24/7 community recreation center, and again, highly amenitized is what they're looking for. Great central location.
Shuffleboard.
We got our shuffleboard.
That's
so
fun.
See, but when you look at it, it doesn't look like it would be any different from
of course
something
not.
Else. It's just amazing.
Look at this
community.
House.
Oh, that's beautiful.
And then this community, I love this as well. This is down in Northport, so again, incredible value. This was built in 2014. Again, super affordable. Pretty brand new. This is $214,700. Gorgeous 2-bedroom, 2-bath, 1,500 square feet with a den. And so it's nice and open. You can make it your own. The community, though, is absolutely
beautiful.
Outstanding.
Wow.
Luxurious clubhouse, you know, lighted tennis courts, everything.
That.
So again, they're really making these like the lifestyle type communities as well.
Right.
So that's what draws a lot of people in.
So are they, for example, that pool, would you want to go jump in with kids? Is this the feature that people like? It's quieter? Is that why they would want to live
that's
there?
That's the theme, that it would be quiet and everything. But you know,
but there are some downsides because, you know, it's not always.
Right, and it's interesting. So everyone thinks that everyone in a 55 plus community is over 55. Believe it or not, it's more of an 80-20 rule. And that comes to community specific. So 80% have to be 55 plus.
So they could have let me stay there.
They weren't meeting their numbers.
What about visitors? What if I'm, you know, living in a 55 plus community and I want my grandkids to come stay for a month in the summer?
Sure.
Do I have those options?
Absolutely. And here's the thing about that. The answer to that question is you have to verify that because even though it's a 55 plus, each community will have their own little rules and regulations.
Okay.
So that's a good question to ask before you.
Before you buy it. All right, well, we have some more communities.
Perfect. All right. Love this community. Ooh. This is the Cascades in Sarasota. Again, under $300,000, built 2006. So this is almost 2,200 square feet. Look how incredible this is. A fully updated kitchens and baths, beautiful backsplash, big open floor plan, nice and bright. Again, it's a newer home.
That's beautiful.
Two bedrooms, two baths, and a den. And the community again here, look at this.
Ooh, indoor,
absolutely incredible. 25,000 square foot clubhouse, state of the art, indoor, outdoor pools, all the amenities again in the Cascades. So.
I think the reason people like it is you don't have to do your yard work, you don't have to take up the keep up the pool.
You've got help.
You don't have to do all those things you didn't like to do originally.
No, these communities are like, when I say amazing, you want to live there. I wanted to live there. It was amazing. They have everything laid out for you.
Yep, absolutely.
Like amazing.
And then going on to Siesta Key, this is a famous community. I love this community. Whispering Sands, under $800,000.
Beautiful
magnificent.
Inside.
This has panoramic views of the Gulf of Mexico, fully updated, incredible on the inside. It has that coastal theme to it. So, but this is what it's all about, having that porch out
that
to the Gulf of Mexico.
Siesta Key Beach right
and
there.
And then this, you know, Whispering Sands, what makes it unique is it's on 25 acres of all the amenities right there on the water. So, again, absolutely incredible community on Siesta Key.
And all things considered a good value.
Good
value. Look at that.
Absolutely. That's what I love. Bringing values.
So, this is amazing. And then a dream home.
And then a dream home. So this isn't a 55-plus community, but in the theme of our show, we love to bring the dream home.
Yeah, we can't miss this.
5.2 million.
You have to be over 55 to afford it, probably.
Probably. It's going to take that long to save my life.
Completely custom. It's a four-bedroom, five-bath. We're looking at 6,800 square feet, top to bottom, custom. Absolutely incredible. I mean, Bobeth, 700 bottle wine cellar as well in there.
Okay, that would be
perfect.
A chandelier in the kitchen. There's
chandelier
a sign
in the kitchen.
This is beautiful.
So, and again, this is right in Sarasota. This is right on the water, on the bay, and just incredible. $5.2 million. If you're a boater, you've seen this property, and just love it.
Ooh,
I mean,
I
think you can afford to have someone maintain it for you, too.
Yeah,
absolutely.
You can pay a gardener.
I mean, that's why you need to be 55 to get it. That's why I got a couple
And there's
years.
No one around you, either. Look at how much space
And
you
look,
have.
This looks like it has solar panels, so and it's probably eco-friendly, too.
Very eco-friendly, and my friend Dave Benson in the back took that picture.
Great photo.
All right, well, thank you so much, Andrew. Now, if you want to find out about these homes or any other ones that they may have for sale, you want to go to Andrew at SearchSarasotaHomes.com, and we'll be right back with a preview and sounds of the Suncoast.
Hurricane season is here, and Suncoast weather can go from this to this in seconds. So when severe weather threatens, count on the official Suncoast storm team at ABC 7.
We're armed with the most advanced weather technology so that we can bring you storm warnings faster and with more detail than ever before.
Plus, we focus on the Suncoast and track storms right down to your neighborhood.
On air, online, and on your mobile device, turn to the official Suncoast storm team at ABC 7. We're here for you.
My dad is my hero, and I wanted to give him a chance to live life and be happy. Granny Nannies has been a huge help. It has contributed to the health and happiness of my dad, for sure.
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
Since 1928, Karastan has been setting the standard in carpets and rugs, producing non-allergenic wools that won't promote the growth of bacteria or dust mites like other carpets will. Karastan wools actively remove contaminants from the indoor air, making your home healthier. And there are many colors and patterns and textures to choose from. Come see for yourself.
So many possibilities worth exploring. Minnesota Flooring.
They took that stress and that tension when I was particularly feeling very bad after that nasty car accident. And it was such a relief to know that I didn't have to bear that burden alone, that I had help.
Our goal is to not just get a satisfactory settlement on their case. We want them up on their feet, happy again. They've gotten their life back.
Don't miss the Weddings of Sarasota 16th Annual Wedding Show at the iconic Sarasota Municipal Auditorium on US 41, Sunday, August 28th from noon to 4 p.m. The runway show is on the stage at 3 p.m. Enjoy hors d'oeuvres and live entertainment. $2,000 in Weddings of Sarasota dollars will be given away after the runway show, but you must be present to win. Make sure to pre-register at weddingsofsarasota.com. Brides and grooms are free if registered by midnight, August 26th. Guests only $5. Weddings of Sarasota. Register today.
Granny Nannies. We've been making house calls for over 25 years. When you need home health care services, there really is no place like home.
Grandma!
A helping hand and a gentle heart.
welcome back. Get ready for a hand clap and toe tap and good time for free at Friday Fest at the Van Wezel. Rebel Heart is a high-energy new country band that covers contemporary country's greatest hits. And they're here in studio with us for today's Sounds of the Suncoast. Take it away, guys.
Come on, baby, now rock with me. You sing the words and I'll bring the beat. No love song ever sounded this sweet. Come on, baby, now rock with me. You got my heart kicking like a big bass drum. Couldn't carry a tune till I felt your love. So hard to explain what you're doing to me. It's like you took my words and made a sweet melody.
Cause I knew the second that I met you, baby.
Together we're a hit song, kind you wanna sing along. Come on, baby, now rock with me. You sing the words and I'll bring the beat. No love song ever sounded this sweet. Come on, baby, now rock with me. When you're gone, you got me singing the blues. I don't feel like rocking when I'm not with you. Show the grooving on your big guitar. Let's turn it up loud and we can shake the stars. Together we're a hit song, kind you wanna sing along. Come on, baby, now rock with me. You sing the words,
now bring the beat.
No love song ever sounded this sweet. Come on, baby, now rock with. Come on, baby, now rock with me. You sing the words and I'll bring the beat. We're falling in love in harmony. Come on, baby, now rock. Come on, baby, let's rock. Come on, baby, won't you rock with me?
You can see Rebel Heart Friday night at Friday Fest at the Van Wezel. It is from 5 until 9 right on the Sarasota Bayfront, and it's free. Be sure to stop and say hi to us as well at our ABC7 booth. And for more information, you can go to vanwezel.org. Coming up next, we've got Southeastern Guide Dogs here with a puppy. We can't wait. But first, we want an encore. Rebel Heart, play us out.
We're gonna rock it out on Friday night at the Van Wezel from 5 to 9. All ages can come on now, cause Rebel Heart's gonna rock it out. We gonna rock it. Yeah, we gonna rock it.
Since 1972, Sleep King has provided quality mattresses and accessories at the best discounted prices available. Top brands like Simmons, Sealy, Serta, Beautyrest, iComfort, and more. With available free delivery, free financing, and free setup and removal. For a comfortable night's sleep with same-day delivery, even if we have to carry it on our backs. Trust Sleep King of Sarasota. Buy it today. Sleep on it tonight.
We've been slow smoking over oak for more than 45 years. And while sticking to tried and true traditions is kind of our thing, it doesn't hurt to throw something new in the smoker every now and then. Come get some slow smoked chicken wings at Sonny's Barbecue. Order them as an appetizer or as part of a combo with pork, baby back ribs, or both, starting at $10.99. Sonny's Barbecue, local pitmaster since 68.
Do you have what it takes to become a champion? The Sarasota YMCA Shark Swim Team has been developing champions since 1961. Fall swim team tryouts for kids ages 6 through 18 are being held August 15th through the 18th and August 22nd to the 25th, from 5:30 to 6:30 p.m. Tryouts are held at the Evelyn Sadler Jones Branch, YMCA's Selby Aquatic Center. For more information, visit sarasotaymca.org/sharks.
Has chronic knee pain, arthritis, or osteoarthritis of the knee robbed you of your mobility? Would you like your pain-free life back again? Then call now. You may qualify for a new non-surgical drug-free treatment for knee pain. Even if you've tried other treatments with little or no relief, you may still be a candidate for our Advanced Arthritis Relief Protocol. This emerging treatment is covered by most insurance, including Medicare. Suffer no longer. Call right now and get your mobility back.
The official salon of ABC7.
So, you've decided to go to college. That's cool. So, pop quiz. Which is a better way to earn your degree? Commute to college and fill your gas tank, get stuck in traffic, drive in bad weather, try to find a parking space, walk a half mile to class, or learn online at Independence University? You don't go to college. College goes to you. That's Independence. That's Independence University. And all your supplies, including a brand new laptop and tablet, are included with tuition. Independence U, for an independent you.
1-800-350-9872.
Welcome back to Suncoast View. We're going to introduce you to this cutie in just a minute. But first, let's check back in with Chef Mike from Station 400. And Chef, we talk a lot about Brinner, breakfast for dinner. And I understand we can have breakfast all day with you at Station 400.
Yes, most definitely. We have our menus all day, whether if you want to have breakfast for lunch or lunch for breakfast. either option is definitely available.
And do you find a lot of people are eating those breakfast foods all day?
Most definitely. Actually, my wife is not a big breakfast person, so when she comes in, she'll grab lunch and vice versa. So it works out really well that our menus open all day.
All right. We love it. Thank you. We'll see you in a few minutes. Linda?
We are busy getting ready for our new addition, our Southeastern guide dog puppy. Stephanie, fortunately, is going to be the puppy raiser in the group with Southeastern guide dogs, but we need your help in picking a name for our future superhero. Larissa Daigle from Southeastern guide dogs is here today to explain why a guide dog's name is so important. Why is that, Clarissa?
Good afternoon.
Hello.
Well, I will tell you, the name is important for a couple of reasons. One, our puppies are all named by sponsors who support Southeastern Guide Dogs.
Oh.
And in order to do that, they make a gift to Southeastern Guide Dogs, and part of that is to be able to name the puppy. So the puppy is named using perhaps a name that might be special to them, or perhaps in memory of someone, mm-hmm. or perhaps a pet that they've had in the past. So. Also, once the dog is given to its handler, then they'll want to make sure that they have a name that goes throughout the puppydom and the training and all the way through till the dog is given to his handler.
Oh, yeah. So people don't keep giving this dog
exactly.
different names along the way.
Exactly.
Well, now, how do you pick those names once the sponsor says, mm-hmm. this is what I'd like to name it?
Sure.
How do you pick?
Sure. So usually we ask them for a couple of different choices because mm-hmm. we have about 250 puppies a year that come through Southeastern Guide Dogs. We breed and raise them. And so as you can imagine, there are a lot of names that have to be sort of recycled if we have names that perhaps might come up more than mm-hmm. once. So we ask our sponsors to give us a couple of choices. Typically they would... suggest names. Sometimes they're names of humans. Sometimes they're names, funny names. And then they actually have to pass a curb test.
What's a curb test?
A great question. So a curb test, as you can imagine, these dogs are really, we consider them superheroes, and they're incredibly well-trained, mm-hmm. and they're really wonderful dogs that are so important to give folks their independence. And so our handlers will be walking along, for example, imagine a busy street and imagine a dog being asked to sit. So, for example, if we want to have a name that is comfortable for the handler to use, within earshot of other people.
Okay,
are there names that you can't give them?
I imagine.
Yes.
What? Even in a curb shot of other people, so no, nothing too extreme or cursing or things like that. It has to be PG kind of thing.
Any other names that just don't work?
Well, for example, let me give you sort of an interesting example. We had a name that was submitted recently, and the name was Beach, which really is a lovely name for Florida, correct? But imagine if you were on a busy street corner and heard someone say, "Sit, Beach."
That would get a little uncomfortable. Yeah, that would.
And
you know what I also wonder too, though, because sometimes animals have personalities. Sometimes I would think you want the dog to be named after its personality, like if it's an active thing.
Yeah, this one's active. Maggie's active.
So how do you handle that?
You're not going anywhere.
Well, you know, we do have a little bit of discretion. So, for example, when someone submits a name, there are a lot of things that have to happen to get that name to be placed with a puppy. So when that name comes up, actually we have someone on our staff who does that and does that beautifully well. We'll sort of work with our kennel staff, our puppy kennel staff, to look at the current litters. And there may be a dog who's really, really, you know, sort of rambunctious and robust and might be a yellow female. Someone may have requested a female name. And so we might say, you know, Scooby-Doo or something like that might be a really good name for a robust female. So there is a little bit of art and science as well.
My dog was a career change dog, and his name was Murphy. He got Murphy when he was born.
That's a great
name.
I was
always proud of that. Now, you've got a short list of the names you can give the Southeastern Guide Dog Puppy, don't you, Stephanie?
We do. So we have some really exciting news. We need you to help us name our Southeast Guide Dog Puppy. So we have worked with Southeastern Guide Dogs to come up with a short list, because these are all puppy approved. So here they are Radar, also Blitz.
Love it.
I know Linda's liking that one. We can't vote though. We need everyone else too. Wrigley.
Chewing gum.
Also Tito. And finally, Scoop. So Radar, Blitz, Wrigley, Tito, and Scoop. And what we need you to do is go to our Suncoast View Facebook page, where there is a poll, and vote for the name that you think our Suncoast View guide dog should have. And we're very excited about that as well. And Larissa, you have also been a puppy raiser, correct?
I have.
All right, tell us what we have to look forward to.
It's really a blast, Stephanie. It's going to be probably the most challenging and fun and exciting and really rewarding job you'll ever have. Perhaps after child. But very similar, many very similar things.
Absolutely. Well, this Maggie girl here has given lots and lots of hugs, and I can tell she is very excited to go be a future superhero.
Well, has ours been born yet?
I don't know. I would guess it has been born yet. I think you're probably scheduled to receive it perhaps next month or so.
Yeah, we're just a few weeks out. Right. Oh, so Linda, it has been born. We just don't know who it is yet.
You know what they say, exciting. Stephanie, you get a lot of sleep because you won't be sleeping after
have a new
the puppy
baby
comes
in the family.
And again, you can help name it by going to facebook.com/mysuncoastview. We want to see which one of those names you like. Next, we're going to have a beer collaboration.
The official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC7. We're here for you.
I'm not your spokesperson. This is an important message for anyone who took the prescription drug Xarelto or Pradaxa and had a serious bleeding event. If you or a loved one took Xarelto or Pradaxa and suffered from a serious bleeding event,
call 800-220-8268 immediately.
Xarelto and Pradaxa have been linked to serious internal bleeding, stroke, and death.
Call 800-220-8268 immediately.
You may be entitled to compensation. Call now for a free consultation.
From our studios on Florida's Suncoast, this is an ABC7 News Update.
Good afternoon. I'm Haley Wilgus. Here's what we're working on for 5 o'clock. A big victory for Siesta Key. Sarasota County Commissioners asked for an in-depth study on whether dredging at Big Pass is the best way to shore up Lido Key. Plus a vote that will decide whether a new hotel will go up on Longboat Key. Why some business owners are for the proposal. Now, let's head over to Bob.
Thanks, Haley. We're still watching two systems. Gaston out there in the Atlantic continues to move away from any kind of land area. This one is a disturbance still. It possibly could become a tropical depression or storm within the next couple of days. The center of rotation appears to be right about here, while all the deep convection is well to the south and east, so it's poorly organized at this point, but it does have a chance to develop. We'll talk more about that, obviously. Some storms have worked their way through already. Another line developing. I look for scattered showers through the evening. More on that coming up at 5. See you then.
The all-new MySuncoast.com. Just another way, we're here for you.
Welcome to the all-new Seymour Buick GMC on the island of Venice.
Seymour smiles.
Seymour selection of quality new and pre-owned vehicles.
Seymour for your trade-in.
Seymour savings.
Discover the new Buick and get cash back for up to 16% of the MSRP on select 2016 Buick vehicles. That's nearly $8,000 cash back on this Buick LaCrosse.
Seymour now at Seymour Buick GMC on the island of Venice. Go to SeymourBuickGMC.com.
Are the credit card bills closing in on you? Sick and tired of the constant struggle just to stay afloat? Shouldn't this be the year you get a fresh start? Well, now you can settle your debts with dignity and without bankruptcy. With zero upfront or monthly fees, get the professional help at the Thomason Law Group and get a fresh start. It's easy to sign up. We do all the real work. Better than credit consolidation or credit counseling, the Thomason Law Group uses the power of legal professionals to settle your debts. You don't have to face this alone. We can help with an affordable monthly payment. Call now if you have over $15,000 in debt and settle your debts so you can have hundreds more each month. Don't put this off. Legal settlement can get you fast, easy debt resolution and let you get back to the important things in life.
Call the Thomason Law Group at 1-800-394-1667. That's 1-800-394-1667.
Beer drinkers rejoice! A new craft beer debuts this week on the Suncoast, and it's a partnership between a well-known restaurant group and award-winning local brewery. Here to tell us all about Everybody's Blonde is Mick Cohn from Evie's. And you know what? I have to tell you guys, I had to do that multiple times.
Everybody.
What's going on?
A lot of words there. Yeah. Everybody. I like that.
Everybody blonde.
Everybody's blonde. Everybody needs a blonde.
Everybody needs a blonde, right, Linda?
That's why I'm here, yes.
Okay, so what is this play on words?
Yeah.
Well, it's a very sessionable beer, so everybody can enjoy it, but also we're kind of teaching everybody phonetically how to say
Evies.
Because you do get
you're not Evies.
We do, and we certainly don't mind, but we are Evies for sure.
Well, you're
Everybody's
blonde.
Yes.
I think I messed it up. Everybody's blonde.
There you go.
That's okay. As long as you enjoy it, we don't mind.
Okay, well, let's start talking about it. So tell me a little about this partnership between Darwin and you guys, and how did this all come about?
Well, Darwin and Evie's has been supporting each other since their inception. Mm-hmm. We've formulated a great relationship. They're fantastic people, and they brew really good beer. Mm-hmm. So we have been selling their beer for a while, and they invited us to brew a batch of beer with them, which we gladly accepted the invite.
That's great. Your awesome pizza and beer, they go hand in hand.
They do. Really they good. Do, absolutely. And we're really proud of this beer. It's delicious, as you guys can tell.
We haven't had it yet.
Can we have some? Are we allowed?
Well, it for me to keep you from enjoying the beer.
It's like a big tea. Yeah.
Absolutely.
You don't put beer in front of us and tell us not to touch it.
Absolutely.
Tell us about what we're tasting.
Absolutely. You're a very light, sessionable summertime beer, mm-hmm. clocking at about 5.2%. You'll notice the Citra hops lend a little bit of a fruity, mm-hmm. citrusy flavor mm-hmm. to it. Nothing too overly hoppy, though. Nothing too bitter. Mm-hmm. Great to be paired with just about everything on our menu. It's that user-friendly and...
user-friendly beer.
It's absolutely user-friendly.
Everybody will like it.
Everybody should like it. And they can get it at all our locations, including the White Buffalo, the Office Bar SRQ, and Spanish Point.
So it's going to be widely distributed?
Only to our locations right now. But I do think that they might be brewing another batch of it. This is actually their first blonde ale that Darwin has ever done.
Oh, wow.
And it has turned out so good that we're going to keep doing it.
So it's already in. It's already in the restaurants and in the...
Coming this Friday.
This Friday is when
we're blowing it out. And we're having a really cool special. We've got this 20-ounce English pint glass. It will fill up for $5 at all of our locations until we run out of glasses.
And I hear there's a celebration.
Or beer.
One of the two. I hear there's a celebration aligned with this, right?
Yeah, it's a big party day. Listen, beer is meant to be enjoyed. The camaraderie of beer is what we believe in. Mm-hmm. And we're trying to make this Friday, if not this whole weekend, a big party at all the Evie's locations.
Well, and especially to celebrate that Darwin partnership. Tell us a little bit. You brought us a couple other Darwin beers to remind us what they're doing. Right in Bradenton, correct? This is a
right by McKechnie Field. You can't miss them. It's a gorgeous location. To my left, right in front of you, is the Summer Days, which is their IPA. It's nice, malty, hoppy, bitter IPA, which is one of my favorite styles.
And you serve this at Evie's traditionally, correct?
Not necessarily that one, but that wheat beer.
The
Circa 1926 is a nice citrusy wheat ale, which is, again, another user-friendly beer that we like so much at Evie's.
That's my new favorite term, user-friendly.
Right?
And, you know, you have also recently opened a new location in downtown Sarasota.
Oh, yeah.
So people can go to that location and enjoy all of this?
Friday, you can bowl a couple games, have a couple Everybody's Blondes, and
it is a lot of fun.
I like how he says it. It kind of rolls off his tongue.
It's a great name. Yeah. Everybody will have a good time.
Everybody should have a good time. And everybody should get a party.
And everybody should have a blonde.
Absolutely.
Yes, Linda and I have been saying that for years. All right, we need a cheer. Everybody needs to cheer.
Uh-oh.
Oh, you got left out. You can use the growler.
Yeah.
I came here to get you ladies tipsy.
Okay. Oh, I don't know about that. But cheers to Evie's and Darwin.
Cheers. Well, thank you for having
us. And remember,
y'all,
you can head to any Evie's location on Friday for Everybody's Blonde and get all the information about them. Or just go to their website, Evie's.com, Evie'sOnline.com. All right, we'll be right back.
40 Carats Family Center and the Community Foundation of Sarasota County present a free speaker event, The Gift of Failure, How the Best Parents Learn to Let Go So Their Children Can Succeed. Featuring author and educator Jessica Leahy at Hyatt Regency Sarasota on Monday, September 12th. Discover how to motivate kids to learn for the sake of learning. Wean kids off rewards, bribes, and parental reminders, and approach parenting as a journey toward competence. RSVP required at 40carats.org. That's FORTYcarats.org.
If you're one of the millions of Americans who are disabled and unable to work, I have an important message. You may be entitled to receive disability benefits through Social Security. You'll be matched up with an advocate who will evaluate your situation, handle your application, deal with Social Security for you, and handle all appeals and hearings. Best of all, there are no upfront fees, so you pay nothing until you receive your benefits.
Call the Citizens Disability Helpline today for a free, no-obligation consultation.
They're coming from Tampa, Fort Myers, even Orlando. They're coming from everywhere for the Sarasota Ford Promise. We promise we're more than a dealership. We're a destination with a movie theater, massage room, aquarium, cafe, and more. We promise to give you top dollar for your trade, even if you don't buy from us. And if you do, we promise you the best deal. Bring us any competitor's ad and we'll beat it by at least $1,000. That's why they're coming from everywhere to Sarasota Ford, where 41 meets 301. SarasotaFord.com.
Attention breast cancer survivors. If you experience permanent hair loss or baldness after chemotherapy, you may qualify for a cash award. Thousands of women suffering breast cancer were given a chemotherapy drug without being warned about the possibility of irreversible alopecia. If you or a loved one suffered permanent hair loss after chemotherapy, call 888-622-8732. Time to file a claim is limited. 888-622-8732. That's 888-622-8732.
A message from the Pulaski Law Firm. For decades, many Americans working in the trades were exposed to environmental hazards without their knowledge. While the dangers of one such airborne threat, asbestos, have long been known, efforts were made to hide the risks from the public. The result? Thousands of cases of asbestos-induced mesothelioma. Those in the trades may have been harmed by hundreds of companies who produced asbestos-laden products. The U.S. Bankruptcy Court has established asbestos trusts with $30 billion in initial funding. You may be entitled to financial compensation without ever going to court. If you or someone you know has been diagnosed with mesothelioma, get the best care available. Then call us.
Call 800-279-1837.
For nearly two decades, we've been fighting for those harmed by asbestos. Act now. Call for a free consultation and see how we can help. Mesothelioma. Don't fight it alone.
Welcome back. Okay, something to chat about. You know how websites and apps like, say, iTunes ask you to agree to those terms of service? You have to read all this stuff. Do you actually read them or do you just scroll down and click?
Never. I scroll down and click.
Well, you better be careful what you're agreeing to. So NYU, New York University, actually went so far as to make a fake agreement up, including in it, is it cool if we share all your info with the NSA? And your firstborn child will be part of your payment. Not surprisingly, listen to this, 98% of people agreed anyway.
I believe it.
Nobody pays any attention.
Yeah.
Data shows that it would take the average internet user 76 days of their life to read all the terms and agreements that are out there for us.
Yeah.
But experts do say there's a couple of things we should do, and I thought this was very, very helpful. If you hit Control F, it will search a document, and you should search certain words like third parties, arbitration, and waive. And if you do, then it will get rid of, or at least highlight, those sections so you know what to read. And oh, by the way, sections in all caps, usually worth
really
reading.
Important.
Doesn't mean it's going to be anything bad, but if they say they're going to sell your firstborn, don't you think you should know?
But some of those things you can't not agree. You have to get the service. Like,
you
for instance,
like
they won't let you move forward unless you agree to it.
Right.
So you think
it's not
with
like
some
I can
of these
say
big companies,
yes or
it's
no.
probably okay.
Well, you have to figure, is this worth my firstborn child?
Like, I don't know. I do like Wi-Fi. Yeah. Wi-Fi might be worth it.
Like, what's the risk here?
Yeah, nope. They got us between a rock and a hard place there. Okay, we are headed to the kitchen with Station 400. We're going to learn about chicken salad and croissants.
The official Suncoast Storm Team at ABC 7. We're here for you.
Hi, I'm Dylan Radigan. The world is brimming with possibilities. That keeps me busy. My latest invention may be able to feed and sustain communities around the world. My team and I are always on the go, meeting new people and seeing new places. I produce films that I really care about. It's an honor to speak to audiences around the world. When people come together, meaningful work gets done. How do I do all this? Well, that part's easy. Hotelplanner.com.
From our studios on Florida's Suncoast, this is an ABC 7 News Update.
Hello, I'm Scott Dennis. Here's what's coming up at the top of the hour. A one-on-one interview with Donald Trump. ABC 7's Alan Cohn talks directly to the Republican presidential nominee moments before his rally in Tampa. What Trump wants to do about the funding fight over Zika. That's coming up at 5. Taking a quick look at Suncoast Traffic Watch right now. High wind advisory up for the Sunshine Skyway Bridge as drivers are being asked to be extra cautious there on the bridge. Now over to Bob for more on our weather. Bob?
That's right. Strong northeasterly winds, and that's a result of a high-pressure ridge. Nothing to do with this tropical system that we are monitoring. The low-level circulation appears to be here void of any thunderstorms, meaning that it's not getting its act together, which is a good sign, but their chances are increasing that it will be develop into a tropical cyclone in the next couple of days. Some showers were around earlier, more moving through parts of Port Charlotte. Details on your forecast at 5.
ABC 7, your Suncoast News. We're here for you weeknights at 5. It's time for My Suncoast's Bark in the Park with the Bradenton Marauders at McKechnie Field. Bring your best friend and let them run the bases August 28th at 1 p.m. Visit BradentonMarauders.com for info. Sponsored by ABC 7.
Pearl Cream by Dr. Anna, known as the facelift in a bottle, is an all-natural anti-aging formula that tightens skin and muscles, making you look younger. It's made in Sarasota with real pearls, Chinese herbs, and no preservatives. Visit our store or at pearlcreambydranna.com.
Is your old garage door stuck or broken? Would a new one give you a lift? Let Precision Door Overhead Garage Door Service of Sarasota come to the rescue with prompt and affordable repair service. Replacement doors come with an array of styles and colors, and they are rated to meet and exceed Florida standards. From estimates to installation, your satisfaction is our priority. If you're not 100% satisfied with any product, service, or installation, we will make it right, because Precision Door Service is a name you can trust.
People ask me all the time, George, what do I do with my idea for a new product? I tell them,
Call my friends at InventHelp.
Call InventHelp today for free information. InventHelp has been providing patent referrals, preparing ideas, and submitting to companies for more than 30 years.
I believe every inventor deserves the opportunity to step into the ring and take their best shot. Put InventHelp in your corner.
For your free inventor's information, call 1-800-881-6805.
It's Lincoln Summer Sales Event here at Alex Karras Lincoln. Drive a brand new 2017 Lincoln MKZ for only $299 per month, or a 2016 Lincoln MKX, Lincoln's premium sports utility vehicle, for $339 per month. We also have a great selection of certified pre-owned vehicles. Drive with the confidence of a 6-year, 100,000-mile comprehensive warranty and complimentary roadside assistance. Alex Karras Lincoln, family-owned and operated, and winner of the prestigious 2015 President's Award. We are located 2 miles north of the Sarasota-Bradenton Airport on US 41.
Using baby powder or talc may lead to ovarian cancer. $72 million was awarded in a recent talc lawsuit after lawyers found secret internal documents showing that the baby powder manufacturer knew about the link between talcum powder and ovarian cancer for decades, but never told the public. If you were diagnosed with ovarian cancer after using talcum powder on a regular basis, you may qualify for a cash award. Call 800-793-6621. 800-793-6621.
Coming up Thursday at 4 on Suncoast View, we're celebrating Burger Day. We'll learn the basics for the best juicy burgers in the kitchen. Plus, our gadget guru is going to bring us some tricks and tools to barbecue and grill. A special stunt act that is a throwback to a Coney Island sideshow is coming. You will not believe what you're going to see. Plus, our celebrity makeup artist, Mickey Williams, is back with skincare.
Welcome back. We're in the kitchen with Chef Mike from Station 400. We're going to be making a chicken salad, but it looks like we have a little bit of a twist going on. This is not your ordinary chicken salad.
No, we do have a little bit of twist. We have some spicy green mustard, honey, orange segments in there. It gives us our little twist at Station 400.
Well, Linda and I are going to attempt to make it, so you've got to show us how. And then you can make this at home for the grandkids.
Yes.
You're going to start off with mayonnaise. You can dump that into the mixing bowl there. The whole, it's about
is
2.5 cups.
2.5 cups?
Yep.
2.5 cups.
Regular mayonnaise, none of that Miracle Whip stuff.
We want the real stuff.
How about fat free? No.
Not if you want the taste, no.
All right.
If you want to be healthy, then definitely yes.
Almost
use that,
all in but, there.
Yeah. And
okay.
Then move on to just a little bit of that spicy mustard there.
Okay. Just spicy how grain. Much about just, that?
Yeah, about that. That's perfect.
So like a teaspoon?
Yes.
Okay.
And then,
lot.
No. And then honey. Just
ooh,
a little drizzle, about another teaspoon of there. Just
all
give
right.
it a little
There's
sweet
a secret
taste.
Ingredient. Yep. I like
very
that.
Interesting.
Yep. Okay. We and like little
And then we're
sweets.
Gonna do some fresh orange segments is there. Probably about half of that in there. It's about,
Or all of them. Sorry. I like the...
And then just finish off with a little bit of salt.
You need
a little kosher salt.
We need a pinch.
Yeah, a little pinch. There you go.
All right, now I can stir it up.
Yeah, just incorporate that completely. Get it all nice and mixed in. Now, the best thing to do with this is to actually let it sit overnight so that all those flavors can kind of melt in together and be really
Ooh,
good.
Yeah, and the refrigerator, it
Yes,
melts
most
really
definitely
well.
Covered in the refrigerator.
Let
yes.
it sit before you add the chicken,
Correct.
Just the dressing.
Correct.
Oh, okay,
yep.
that's good to know.
Yeah,
okay.
And we cooked off chicken yesterday as well, so that you have to chop it up and cube it up. If you try to do it hot, all you're going to do is shred up the chicken.
Make a mess.
Oh. Yeah, so
oh.
we roasted the chicken off, and then you let it chill,
okay.
And then you cube it up when you're done
How
with that.
How do you prevent it from getting hard?
Right, Linda?
You just cover it inside the refrigerator, and it'll be fine. And by the time you're ready to use it, it'll be fine with the chicken.
And so. Tell us about the chicken. Is that all parts of the chicken or just breasts?
Chicken breast. We use the chicken breast, just
okay.
white meat.
Okay.
Okay.
Yep.
Okay. There you go, Linda.
Okay, I've got it.
Yeah.
Well,
just
so when you're ready
that.
To make it right then, that sandwich, that's when you want to incorporate everything
Correct.
Together?
Correct. Yes, okay. definitely. And as she's mixing it up there, we'll go ahead and move it over to our finished product here.
Looks amazing.
Another little step that we have is we make our own mango chutney.
Oh.
And it has raisins, curry powder, ginger, roasted peppers, and it's great. And that's going to be the topper. Bobeth over here is going to cut our fresh baked croissants that we make every morning.
So
why go with croissants versus, you know?
Just again, a little twist to make it different. There's tons of chicken salad croissants out there, but to give it our own little special flavor, we use a croissant, nice buttery flavor to it, and it works really well.
Okay.
So if you want, we can go over here and we'll build it right here. Just do a little bit of lettuce on there. Mm-hmm. So if I don't get my face cut. And
yeah. Watch out, she's got a knife.
We'll do top it off with the tomato. And
I'll pass that down to you and the chutney.
Yes.
Yummy.
Over here. Just
all right,
nice
and one of the many sandwiches on Station 400's menu, but you told us this was one of the most popular.
Yeah, this is definitely ranked as one of our crowd favorite up at Station 400.
Wow. And oh, then, that looks cool.
It looks like a piece of art.
Yes, and then we just top it with our house-made mango chutney. And fold it over. And
Mark's stomachs are grumbling.
And tell us about your choice of sides. I see a fruit cup, but what is this? This looks interesting.
That is our tomato cucumber salad, and it's topped with an olive tapenade and balsamic as well, balsamic dressing on top. And then we brought our traditional house fruit salad and our orzo pasta, which is topped with an olive tapenade as well.
All right, well, that looks amazing. Well, Beth, you made one that looked pretty. Now make one that we can eat. Get back to work.
I got that.
Well, be sure and go visit Chef Mike at Station 400. Not only do they have amazing chicken salad, but also some great mimosas, too. We enjoyed the elderflower cucumber mimosa. So, Chef, whip up some more of those for us. We'll get some sandwiches going and celebrate the end of the middle of the week. Happy Wednesday, everybody. Rebecca, thanks for joining us.
Thank you. Thank you for letting me make the chicken.
Everybody enjoy the rest of your day. Be sure to take some time and enjoy the Suncoast view.